Hey guys, what's up? It's Ravi from Tech Shack, and today is another episode of Tech Shack Weekly. So it's Tech Shack Weekly episode number 7. Now, if you're new to this channel, please do subscribe and also turn on post notifications to get the best videos as I make news related to tech and also make montages and sometimes gaming videos, but usually montages and tech news is what I'm known for. So name Tech Shack comes from there. So please do subscribe and turn on post notifications to get the best of the best videos and to be part of the notification gang. Hey. Also follow my Instagram at techshack.yt where I post, stuff exclusive to the Instagram stuff. So it's different from the YouTube content, but sometimes I do post announcements and whatsoever, also tech news in the middle of the week because I only do this once a Sunday. So if there's any news in between that period, I do post it on my story. So please do follow at techshack.yt for the best of the best tech news, also with opinions. Yeah, so wow, this week was pretty juicy in terms of news. First of all, thank you so much for all of you watching my latest montage called Ooh La La, which was amazing. Honestly, the amount of feedback I got was really good. I did keep it on waiting, so I'll be sure to put out another montage next week, preferably on another song, which I'm also planning on doing. So stay tuned for that and also subscribe again. So firstly, there was the Apple event, which showcased the four models of the iPhone 12, which is 12 mini, 12, 12 Pro and 12 Pro Max, which is too much. So what are the changes between this year and last year's model? First, I'll be talking about the 12 Pro and the Pro Max versions. I have the 11 Pro Max, and apparently they have increased the size of the 12 Pro and 12 Pro Max by 0.2 inches. So the Pro Max becomes 6.7 and the Pro becomes 6.1 inches. The Pro is understandable, Pro Max is non-understandable, because it's a huge phone, but still, I think many people like that and they'd like to go for that. And since 2020 is the year of big phone displays, I don't think people would, have a problem about that. The next thing was the inclusion of a LiDAR scanner. So the LiDAR thing is basically used to detect objects using light. So that's a pretty cool concept, and it's a pretty cool way that they have put it into the 12 Pro and 12 Pro Max. Apparently that LiDAR helps in, a better night mode or better autofocus, which is also pretty good. But still, it's not marginally different from last year's model without the LiDAR scanner, but still, there have been improvements to the camera. And since this is the second year of the stub based camera system, I can say that, yeah, it's pretty good. It's a pretty good change. After that, we also got the A14 Bionic chipset, which is the best of the best, best in class Apple chipset, which is basically the best. The amount of times I said the best, wow. So yeah, I think that's been the change between the 12 Pro Max, 12 Pro and 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max, which is understandable because it's only been a 1 year gap, but still, it's a big difference. It's good. Now on to the 11 and the 12. Now the 11 and 12, marginally different cameras. Oh, also they also do get a better camera system, having 12 megapixel wide, 12 megapixel telephoto. So yeah, and this the 12 Pro will have 12 megapixel wide, ultra wide and telephoto. Same camera systems, I guess, as compared to 11 and 11 Pro Max and all that. So 12 gets an improvement in terms of HDR recording. Yeah, all of them do get HDR recording, and they also have the Super Retina XDR display, which is pretty cool in a sort of sense. But still, it sounds amazing. 4K HDR you can watch, and now on YouTube you can basically watch 4K HDR videos on the phone. So yeah, I did have a very satisfying experience watching 4K on the iPhone on literally YouTube, but still, YouTube is compressed quality, but still, there's a marginal difference between watching 1080p video and 4K videos on an iPhone on YouTube specifically. If you watch Netflix, you do get the HDR option, and honestly, it's really good. After that, the 11 mini. So I don't know, I don't get why people want 11 mini. 11 mini is 5.7 inches. Now whoever wants the iPhone 11 mini, 12 mini, sorry, what am I saying? 12 mini, okay, you guys have small hands, maybe you don't want to adjust to the, you know, the 6-inch display world or the gang, you don't want to be part of that. You're still part of that, what do you say, iPhone 5S gang. Yeah, it's the same size as a 6, I'm pretty sure, but the display extends from top to bottom, which is amazing. So people who like the 6 in terms of their size, that's the most perfect option you can ever get. So yes, there's a huge crowd waiting for the 12 mini as well, so I don't have any problems with that. Now coming to the design changes, all of these compared to last year's model, they have the 4S to 5, you know, sharp edge kind of side view kind of a thing. They've changed the design in terms of that, and I really do appreciate Apple for doing that. 11, I don't have a big problem between that, you know, 6 and the 5S, but I know that a lot of people like the 5S design of the side, so yeah. It's a good change, I think. They went back into time to get into that, so that's pretty good. So 1-up points for Apple. Also, all of them get 5G ready. You know, in terms of India, I live in India, 5G won't come anytime soon, so it doesn't matter for me. Now on coming to the pricing in India. Now, this has been a little controversial about Apple's pricing in India. Why is it so expensive? People asking. And, you know, people are like, oh, they start the kidney jokes. Every year a new iPhone releases, yeah, there's the kidney jokes. Apparently, that's what you have to do to be a dank memer in India. You know, every year post kidney jokes about the new iPhone. So, yeah, the iPhone's pricing in India is a little too much. It's about 12 is 79,000. Starting 12 mini is starting from 69,900, 12 pro is starting from 119,000, and 12 pro max is starting from 129,000, I think, which is a little expensive. But since they have the radar technology, or the LiDAR scanner basically uses radar, they have to buy the radar license in India. That's how our rules go. So that's why they're charging us extra. But usually they charge double the amount of what Apple charges for US customers without the tax. So, you know, I don't see a big difference here. Since there's only 1% of India who, you know, usually buys iPhones, I don't think they're troubled by this. That's what I heard from many people who were watching the event. And I also asked them, like, don't you feel this is a little bit expensive in terms of the 12 Pro and 12 Pro Max pricing? But they're like, usually we pay one lakh plus for an iPhone, so it doesn't matter. But since they've changed the entry size from 64 GB to 128 GB, lots of people are like, it's okay, you know, 128 GB, this is the starting price, so I wouldn't argue with that. If it was 64 GB for 119,000, I would have a little bit of a problem. But since it's 128 GB, everyone's not having a problem. So yeah, everything's chill in India. You know, double the price of iPhones, you can go abroad and buy the two phones for the same price. That's how it works. And also the radar license is there, so you can't really complain in terms of that. Now, there was also the HomePod mini, and this is what intrigued my family and I, because we were looking for buying an Alexa or the Echo Dot, which was pretty functional in terms of usage. But since the HomePod mini has come for a price of 9,900, which is basically 10,000 rupees, which is around like 110, or if you just round it off backwards, it's just $100, same price in US, but we just had to add tax, like 3,000 rupees. That's not a lot compared to the iPhones. Yeah, the HomePod mini seems good. It has Siri, which basically most of the people in our house use, so we don't have a problem with that. But still, compatibility might be an issue with other software, but I'm pretty sure all of them are compatible with Apple HomeKit. So, you know, Hue and all that would be compatible. We don't have any Hue lights as such, but still, if you're getting some in future, it would be useful. If I get some money from this YouTube monetized money, I would definitely buy Hue lights, because that's what I've been craving to buy ever since the smart home department launched in India. And I still haven't bought them because it's not that useful for this kind of house. But still, now moving forward into the future, I just want to buy hue lights, change the color to pink and blue, or full on RGB to make it like a gamer's paradise. So yeah, that's my plan. So soon. So HomePod Mini is the cheapest thing I've ever seen in the Apple lineup, and it seems like it's pretty good. With the HomePod being 20,000, this is accurately priced at around 10,000, which is perfect. You know, 50%. And you know, it still packs the same features as the HomePod, is just done in a smaller size and a sphere size, which is nice. So I like the design of the HomePod Mini. Now coming to the PlayStation, now we have lots of news about the PlayStation 5. First of all, the PlayStation 5 pricing details have been revealed. It's $39,990 for the disc edition, or the digital edition without the disc, sorry. And the PS5 normal edition is about $49,000. Now, looking at the pricing, it's a little too expensive compared to what they sell in US, but you know, it's fine. I think no one's gonna buy this year. I was planning to buy this year, but I don't feel the need to buy this year because all of the games that are coming this year are upgradable to PS5 for free. And I have a lot of thoughts about expandability, so I'm not gonna buy this year. But still, if I do start getting my videos monetized, I could maybe look for buying a PS5. But I would never reach that much money. But still, I can contribute some money so my parents can buy it. But I'm not looking to buy this year specifically. Maybe when next year, when the God of War, if they release the God of War edition, I'd buy it because I already have one God of War edition, so I wouldn't mind buying the Ragnarok edition with Thor's scriptures and whatnot. So yeah. Also, we also received some Spider-Man Miles Morales gameplay. Now, the Spider-Man Miles Morales gameplay, it looks very promising, it looks very different, it looks like Queens-like. I love the game because of one reason. Miles, whenever he's traversing through the city, he is very unprofessional, he doesn't know how to swing. So, you know, thumbs up to Insomniac for doing that because he's still learning. In the game, he's still, you know, he hasn't been like Peter Parker, where he spent most like 5 to 6 years on being a hero to this neighborhood. So he doesn't really know how to traverse through the city, and it's really nice how they approach that way. And you know, the spider cat, which is pretty cute. I don't know why I just started to have a liking for cats, but still, yeah, I'm a dog fan, but still, I do like cats. Also, the PlayStation UI has been revealed. Now, PlayStation UI pretty much looks like the concept that I had seen, because if I show the original concept, I don't know, one person had made the PlayStation 5 concept, and this is basically how Sony did their concept reveal of their, you know, opening stuff. It just looks very similar, so I'm pretty sure they borrowed some stuff from him, or they, you know, they gave him credit for that and they used it. So yeah. It does look very nice. It looks very simple, it looks very small, you know, there's a lot of details, which kind of made it complicated for one of my friends. That's what I heard from my friends, but still, I do like the way the games are set around the trophy hunting part, and yeah, it's really good. Also, we received some Cyberpunk trailer. Now, this was the trailer of the cars and how the classes of the cars would be like. So it was like executive, economy, supercars, hypercars, and you know, it was honestly amazing because it really shows the dedication of the team in terms of the art of the cars and how it's relatable to 2077. And I'm not even kidding, my parents saw that and they were like, I think you should pre-order it, because I've been asking them for a long time to pre-order it, but I really didn't feel like pre-ordering it. I usually don't pre-order at least 2 months before the release, because I still need to get news about the game and, you know, what it exactly is so that I like it. The only reason I haven't pre-ordered Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War is the reason that I don't really feel like buying it. I don't have a, you know, last year when it was Modern Warfare, I had a strong need of buying it because it was a very different change in the engine, and you know, it looked vastly different from the last Call of Duty game. And now you see Cold War, not the looks, it's just that the mechanics are pretty stiff, you know. Treyarch has their ways of making animations, Infinity Ward has their way of making animations, it's vastly different. So I really don't feel like the need to buy the game on release, maybe probably like 2 months after release when the price drops a little, because it's 5,000 for the cross-gen bundle, which isn't really worth it when you're upgrading. So I think I'd rather wait on a sale for that cross-gen bundle to drop to maybe 4 or 3.5, which would, you know, probably be rare, but still, let's just wait. Also, I did have a little opinion about the Apple event. I really wish they showcased the new MacBook Pro that they were gonna show when they said fall 2020 in the June event. I'm pretty sure they said that, and there was no news of it. Maybe it might not be a event like a launch, it might just be an intermittent one, but still, guys, come on. Like, I honestly hope to see the new MacBook Pro, and I was really a little bit disappointed in that, but it's okay. And I also expected the new iPad to come with the LiDAR scanner on that day itself with the event, but the only thing they showcased was the iPhones, and it's okay. So I think that's it, guys, for today. It was more of like, I shot this a little late, so I'm pretty sorry if I didn't even, I didn't cover some stuff, or I probably didn't do anything properly. I'm really sorry I shot this a little late. I had some other work to do, I'm really sorry. But I'll be sure to make it up to you guys when the next week with the montages and all that. So I've been working on all that. Don't worry, I have projects also, so I'm doing all of them together. So I'll be a little bit stressed, but still, I'll make sure to post the montages, because it's me, Tech Shack, and I'll make promises. So I'll definitely do it. So at the subscribe to my channel if you like the video, you know, like, also give it a like if you like it, because honestly, helps with the engagement, helps with reach, helps with everything. And if you do that, that would be amazing. So subscribe to the channel, turn on post notifications, like the video, also follow my Instagram at techshack.yt for the latest information, announcements, and exclusive content to Instagram. So, you know, like that. That's how we do it. I think that's it, guys. So stay home and stay safe if you don't have any essential work to do. Keep engaged, keep your mind engaged, stay healthy, and that's it.